Hello students, welcome to our school YouTube channel. As this is my first video, so today we are going to discuss about the first chapter of class 10 science, that is chemical reactions and equations. Okay, so first of all we will be writing about the definition of chemical reaction, that is the transformation of chemical substance into a new chemical substance by making or breaking of bonds between different atoms So here you can see the transformation of a chemical substance into a new chemical substance by making or breaking of bonds between the different atoms. As we already know that things are made up of smaller atoms, okay? So while in a chemical reaction, the bonds between the atoms will either break down or new bonds will be formed in between the atoms. Okay, for example, in lower classes when we got about the chemical reaction, we know that it is a irreversible process where new substances were formed, or you cannot transform the new element or the new product into the original form. Okay, for example, the burning of paper, that is a very good example of chemical reaction. Okay, now if we have to determine that whether a chemical reaction have taken place or not, we may see some observations there to state whether a chemical reaction have taken place or not. So I'm rubbing this portion. Whenever to identify whether a reaction is chemical reaction or not, you may see the observations there. That means there will be a change in state. States were of three types. One was your solid, one is your liquid, and another one is your gaseous, isn't it? That means whenever there will be a chemical reaction, the state will change either from solid to liquid, or liquid to gaseous, or solid to gaseous, and so on. Okay? Next one is the change in color. That means after a chemical reaction, the color of the substance will be changed. A new color will be formed. I will come to the example. Next one is the evolution of gas. Though it is a chemical reaction, there will be a evolution of gas whenever the reaction or after the reaction have taken place. And the next one is given, that is change in temperature. Mostly in case of chemical reactions, the temperature is always increased. So in the first topic we have taken the example of chemical reaction, that is burning of paper, the simplest one. So in this case, when we are saying that burning of paper is a chemical reaction, so you can state that while burning of paper or after burning of the paper, what happens, you see, first of all the state of the paper changes. First the paper was in solid form, right? But whenever we burn it, it will turn into a amorphous state. Amorphous means powder state. Okay, next one is given, change in color. If you are burning any color of paper, white, pink, blue, whatever it is, after burning, what will happen? The color of the paper will obviously change, right? That means the color of the paper after burning will turn into black is gray, like that. So next one is evolution of gas. Obviously we know while burning, the evolution of gas takes place there. And the last one is change in temperature. The temperature of the paper in a normal state, we can touch it, though it is in a room temperature, but while burning or after burning, the temperature increases. That means the temperature changes, right? So we can say that for a particular chemical reaction to occur, there are some observations by which we can state that the chemical reaction has taken place. Those are the change in state, the change in color, evolution of gas, and change in temperature. So you can simply take the example or remember the example of burning of paper. Fine. Let's come to the next topic, that is chemical equation. A chemical equation is nothing but the representation of a chemical reaction. While a chemical reaction takes place, we have to represent it in a certain way. That particular way is known as the chemical equation. So I'm writing the definition here, that is a chemical equation is a way to represent a chemical reaction. Okay, so here we will be taking the example that is given in your book, that is the reaction between magnesium and oxygen, which gives rise to magnesium oxide. Okay, so magnesium plus oxygen will give to magnesium oxide, right? Here what happened? Magnesium reacted with oxygen to give rise to magnesium oxide. It is itself a chemical reaction, and the way that we are using to represent that particular chemical reaction will be known as chemical equation. Or else, by not writing the complete name of the elements, we may use the scientific symbols here. Okay, so magnesium is represented as Mg. Okay, oxygen is O2 and magnesium oxide will be your MgO. So this is your one type of chemical equation. Okay, now your next one is balancing of a chemical equation. Balancing means, you see, there are two parts in a particular chemical reaction, that is this part will be your reactants, that means these two particular elements will be reacting in between them, and this portion, that is the right hand side, will be your product. Clear? So in a chemical reaction there will be two sides, one is your reactant and another one is your product. The reactants are mostly written in the left hand side and the products will be written in the right hand side. Okay, now as we are telling about balancing of a chemical equation, that will be meaning that the total mass of the reaction in the left hand side of the arrow will be equal to the total mass of the product in the right hand side of the arrow. One more thing you note here, this arrow head will be representing at which direction the reaction is taking place. Okay, so balancing a chemical reaction or a balanced chemical reaction or equation is known as the when the total mass of the reactants will be equal to the total mass of the products, it will be known as a balanced chemical equation. Fine. So the first equation that we have taken is Mg plus O2 will give to MgO. Here we can clearly see that the number of elements or the mass of the total elements here in the left hand side of the reactants is not equal to the right hand side, because there is only one molecule of magnesium is there. Okay, one molecule of magnesium is there in the product, but two molecules of oxygen are here in the reactant part, but here only one molecule of oxygen is there in the product part. So to balance that particular equation, what we will do, though here two numbers of oxygen are there, we will be placing 1, 2 in front of the product. Mind it, we can't write the numericals in between the product part. Okay, now you see here two molecules of oxygen and two molecules of oxygen are there, but as the number of magnesium also increase, so we have to put another two in front of the magnesium in the reactant part. Now the total number of or the total mass of the reactants is equal to the total mass of the products. Let us take some examples of balancing equations. First one, Fe, that is your iron, when reacts with water H2O, the product will be Fe3O4 plus H2O. Okay, sorry, H2. Now here you see in the right hand side, in the left hand side, the in the reactant part, the number of iron is lesser than the number of the iron in the product part. So number of iron here in the left hand side is 3, so we will be placing 1, 3 in front of the iron in the reactant part. Next you see, count the number of oxygen here, that is 4 number of or 4 molecules of oxygens are there in the product part. So here only one molecule of oxygen is there in the reactant part, we will be placing 1, 4 in front of the H2O. Fine, but here you can see the number of hydrogen is also increased as you have placed the 4 in front of the H2O. So in the product part also we have to increase the number of H2. Now here after placing the 4 in front of H2, the number of mass or the total mass of the reactants is equal to the total mass of the product, that is 3 molecules of iron here, 3 molecules of iron, 4 molecules of oxygen, 4 molecules of oxygen, and 8 molecules of hydrogen will be equal to 8 molecules of hydrogen. Okay, another very important example we will be taking here, that is the reaction of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, as all of you already know, is a chemical process where carbon dioxide and water reacts in case of autotrophic nutrition, right, in case of plants, with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll, and give rise to glucose, water and oxygen. Fine. So let us take the reaction of photosynthesis. We will be taking the first product will be your carbon dioxide, that is CO2 plus water in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll will give rise to glucose, that is C6H12O6 plus oxygen plus water. This is a complete reaction, but here we have to see that the number of or the mass of the elements in the reactant part is not equal to the mass of the product in the right hand side. So we will be balancing it here. You count the numbers here. One molecule of carbon, we'll take this first one only. The number of carbon here in the left hand side is 1, but the number of carbon in the right hand side, that is 6. So 6 more number of carbons will be required in the left hand side. Okay, now you see 6 number of carbon and 6 to the 12 number of oxygen. For your convenience, you write here 12 number of oxygen here. Now here you count the total number of oxygen in this part and total number of oxygen in this part. Okay, now what will happen, we will be taking 6 molecules of oxygen in the product part and 6 number of water in the product part. Then the count will be equal to 6 to the 12 plus 6 is 18, 18 plus 6 will be your 24. But here the number of oxygen is 12. So 12 more number of oxygen is required to balance the oxygen, mass of oxygen in both the sides. Okay, now you count the total number of mass in both the sides, that is 6 molecules of carbon here, 6 molecules of carbon, next one is your 6 to the 12 oxygen plus 12 oxygen, that is total 24 oxygen. Here you count 6 to the 12, then 6, 18 and 6 number of oxygen, total 24 number of oxygen in the product part as well. And the last one is your hydrogen, 12 number of hydrogen in the reactant part and 6 to the 12 number of hydrogen in the right hand side, that is in the product part. You do note this one, this equation, and try to remember. This is very important. Let us revise our topics one more time. First one was your chemical reaction. A chemical reaction is nothing but the transformation of a chemical substance into a new chemical substance, either by making or breaking the atomic bonds in between them. Then how can we observe that a chemical reaction has taken place? By seeing the state, or the state will be changed. Next one will be change in the color, then evolution of gas, and the last one is your change in temperature. Okay, and your last one is balanced chemical equation, that is whenever the number of mass in the reactant part will be equal to the number of mass, or the mass of the product part will be equal, it will be known as balanced chemical equation. So today we are concluding our topics here. Thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned. Till then, thank you.